all will declare how great is our God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Thank you, worship team. You may be seated. Greetings to you in the beautiful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ this morning. I first of all want to greet our apostle, our pastors, visiting pastors and leaders, and every member in the house of God, especially to our mothers this morning. A beautiful and a blessed Mother's Day to all of us. Ek glo dat julle is net so trots soos ek trots voel oor my kinders. Toe julle is se kinders hier sien, kom ons exclude gaan net die pants, net so for a second. Mamies, ons se kinders, is julle net so trots soos u? Amen. The Bible says, out of the mouths and of babes and sucklings, God ordains praise. So, hulle het vanoggend ons praises gesing en ons is so dankbaar vanoggend vir die Here, vir die opportunity. I'm not going to be long. I don't preach. I love to encourage. So, I'm going to encourage the body of Christ this morning. We can go to Exodus chapter 1 and we are going to read from verse 6. I also want to say to those of you who are celebrating your Mother's Day for the first time, without your mothers, we are thinking and we are praying for you for strength this morning. Amen. It is not easy, but we thank God for sevre Here, dankie vir behoudenis krag. Hallelujah. You know, on Monday morning, I just want to shortly share with you, I woke up and I realized, as amper soos iemand vir my sê, jy kan nie, want jou ma's dood. Jy sal dit kan maak. And instantly in myself, I became fearful because emotions can easily take over. And I said to myself, I am unsure. I don't know what to do. But I thank the Holy Spirit because it is He who gives us the ability to overcome. And I prayed and I asked God to bring every feeling into subjection to the Spirit of God, because I know God wants His word to penetrate this morning. If we have it, we can say amen. Amen. Exodus chapter 1 verse 6, it says, now Joseph and all his brothers and all that generation died, but the Israelites were fruitful and multiplied greatly and became exceedingly numerous, so that the land was filled with them. Then a new king who did not know about Joseph came to power in Egypt. Look, he said to his people, the Israelites have become much too numerous for us. Come, we must deal shrewdly with them, or they will become even more numerous. And if war breaks out, we'll join our enemies to fight against us and leave the country. So they put slave masters over them and oppressed them with forced labor, and they built Pithom and Rameses as store cities for Pharaoh. But the more they were oppressed, the more they multiplied and spread out. So the Egyptians came to dread the Israelites and worked them ruthlessly. They made their lives bitter and hard labor in brick and mortar and all kinds of works in the field. In all their hard labor, the Egyptians used them ruthlessly. Now this morning I would like to title my message, Hebrew woman is not like Egyptian woman. Hebrew woman is not like Egyptian woman. You see, what happens is when we go through pressing and when we go through trials, I'm just going to give you a short background of the Israelites. When they were in Egypt, remember it was because of Joseph that they ended up in Egypt. When Joseph was sold into slavery. So eventually Joseph became prime minister. And amal Joseph se broers en sy patriek toe amal Egypt toe. But after Joseph died, that Pharaoh that Joseph served under, he died. And a new Pharaoh arose. So this Pharaoh didn't know the Israelites. En hulle weet nie, dat was a Israelite seun wat vir hulle deliver het uit famine uit. So this Pharaoh become fearful when he sees that the Israelites is increasing. En toe hulle begin increase, begin sy hart bekommerd raak, want hy dink die mense gaan vir ons overthrow as ons sy enemies gaan kom. Hulle gaat net ons saam met die enemies opgang en dan vir ons overthrow. And the Bible says that work was increased and the labor was increased upon the Israelites. But what is so beautiful that the pressing on the Israelites didn't cause them to curl up and to feel sorry for themselves. The pressing of the Israelites didn't cause them to hide, go into hiding. But instead, the Bible says in verse 12, it says, the more they were oppressed, the more they multiplied and they spread out. You see, if I can bring it home, if we take things in the natural, when you take a milli and you press it, you get something out of it. Isn't it so? And kry ons milliemeel en ons kry Kellogg's en amal die goed. So when you take an olive and you press it, you get olive oil. When you get grapes and you press it, you get grape juice. So that tells me naturally when you something is pressed, it doesn't die. It stretches out and it spreads out. In the natural, and it's so the same applies to us. When the circumstances come, you see, the enemy can only use circumstances to press us. Hy kan net omstandighede gebruik om vir ons te druk of te neer te druk. But what we must do, we mustn't allow the circumstances to press us down. We must spread out and we must produce, we must increase and we must become more. So what happens? Slave masters was placed over the Israelites. En net so kom die duivel en hy sit problems. En die problems is soos 'n slaaf drywer om jou. Al wat jy aan dink is die problem. Al wat jy aan dink is die issue. But God wants us to see this morning, the problem is not supposed to control you. The problem is not supposed to oppress you. The problem is supposed to stretch you out and to break you out and so that you can break forth. So daar is iets wat die duivel gebruik, wat ons oplet vanoggend. He only uses natural occurrences to get to us as children of God. And this morning I want to say to you, don't let the natural things affect you this morning. Let the natural things rather allow you to stretch out and to stretch forth. Verse 12 says so beautifully. It says they used hardship to their advantage. The Israelites used the hardship to their advantage. So wat gebeur het, so meer hulle werk op die manne gesit het, so meer het die vrouens kinders gekry. So meer hulle die manne laat hard werk het, so meer kinders het die vrouens gekry. And it became a problem to Pharaoh, because hy sien toe dat sy plan werkie. Now just so the devil knows, the more he places on you, the more you're going to bring forth. The more he troubles you with problems, the more you're going to produce. The more you see the difficulties and the circumstances, the more you must push in. There is something about you this morning. The Bible says in verse 14, in verse 12, the second part, it says the Egyptians came to dread the Israelites. To dread something is to greatly fear something. The Egyptians het begin te bang raak because they realize dat die mense raak nou al meer en meer. So meer ons vir hulle is oppres, so meer ons druk op hulle plaas, the more they are increasing. The enemy is dreading you this morning. There's a great fear in the atmosphere because of you. The only problem is we don't realize it. Net soos die Israelites, they didn't realize that the Egyptians is actually scared of them. Hulle het nie gesien dat die Egiptenare is eintlik bang vir hulle nie. En hulle het nie gesien die potential wat binne in hulle is nie. But the Egyptians saw it. The Bible says their lives, the Egyptians, verse 14, made their lives bitter. Nou, hoeveel kere wil die omstandighede nie kom om vir ons bitter te maak nie? But we mustn't allow it to make us bitter. We must allow the circumstances to grow us, to expand us, and so that we can stretch forth. Amen? Ons moet nie toelaat dat die duivel vir ons bitter maak nie. The enemy is the one that wants to make us bitter. The Egyptians was the enemy of the Israelites. they wanted to make the Israelites more bitter by placing more work, more strain on them. But let me say, use the circumstances to your advantage. Use it so that you can grow. Use it so that you can step forward. Use it so that you can step upwards. That is why the circumstances is there. 2 Corinthians 4 verse 8. It says that we are hard pressed on every side. It says we are, but we are not crushed. It says that we are perplexed, but we are not in despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. We are struck down, but we are not destroyed. And the same happened to the Israelites. They were pressed, but they weren't crushed. They were persecuted, but they were not abandoned. They were struck down, but not destroyed. And so we must use our circumstances to our advantage. Grow out. You see, instead of when the circumstances come, then we want to curl up and we want to die. And we feel sorry for ourselves and we cry. But instead of curling up and dying, stretch out and stretch forth. Instead of curling up and dying, stretch up, stretch out and stretch forth. And increase in your circumstances this morning. Don't allow your circumstances to control. Verse 12 says, the Egyptians became so fierce. They became so fearful of the Israelites. That Pharaoh, hy beraam nog 'n plan. Hy sê vir die voetvroue, as haar boys gebore word, dan maak julle vir hulle dood. En as haar seuns, as haar dogters gebore word, then you spare them. Maar die voetvroue kan dit eens manage. Die voetvroue kan eens die saak manage. What happens is, before the babies of van die voetvroue kom, dan is die babas al reeds gebore. Farao is kwaad, want hy wil weet waar hy gaan toe. Hoe? Ek het dan vir julle instruction gegee, wat moet julle doen? The Bible says that he summons us, the midwives, and he asked them, wat gaan aan? Hier staan nou klomp babies, boy babies wat in die rond is. The midwife says, Egyptian woman is not like Hebrew woman. Die midwife sê, wanneer ons daar kom, dan het hulle al klaar boord geboorte gegee. The midwife says, they are vigorous women. When we sit them on the birth stool, and sien ons net daar, sy kind al klaar. I checked, what is a birth stool? A birth stool is two stones that they put ready. So die vrou moet so sit dat die kind deur die gap val. Die vrouens het hier antwoord die. The midwife says they are so vigorous. I check the meaning of vigorous. Vigorous means they are too strong. Vigorous means they are too active. Vigorous means they are too robust. Vigorous means they are too forceful. Hebrew woman, I'm speaking to the Hebrew woman this morning. It is time for you to become forceful. It is time for you to become robust. It is time for you to become active in the things of God. It is time. It is time. It is time. As ek dit in my eie woorde kan sê, Hebrew woman is not like Egyptian woman. As ek my eie terme kan gebruik, chickens are not like eagles. Chickens are not like eagles. There's a vast difference between the two. I told you a few Sundays ago what eagles does and what chickens does. Wanneer die pap dik raak, dan loop die hoenders rond. Soos af met afkop, hulle weet nie wat om te maak nie. But the eagle in the circumstances, she takes advantage of her circumstances. She decides in herself to use the currents of the wind, and she spirals up with the currents of the wind. Eagles and chickens, as a groot verskil. Woman of God, I want to speak to you this morning. It is time for us to come up. It is time for us to spread out. It is time for us to break through. You see, we have many excuses. Ek het ook 'n klomp excuses gehad. We have many excuses. We are hiding behind our chores. We are hiding behind our husbands. We are hiding behind our children. We are hiding behind our problems. We are hiding behind financial lack. We are hiding behind many things. But it is time this morning to break free and to break out. Don't use your circumstances as an excuse not to come out. Use your circumstances to your advantage this morning. Use it to your advantage. You see, woman, it is time for us to step out in prayer. Vital, vital, vital. Iets wat ons nie altyd lief is om te doen nie. It is time for us to step out in prayer. When I think about my mother, I remember how she took me. I was 8 years old. When she starts praying at the bed, I must pray with her. She developed a prayer warrior when I was 8 years old. You have your daughters and you have your sons. You don't know who you are busy raising up. You don't know if you are raising up the next pastor. You don't know if you are raising up the next evangelist. So it is your duty to take your children, to teach them in the ways of the Lord. You don't know if you are raising up the next president. So it is your duty. Woman, I'm speaking to the woman specifically this morning. Take your place. Don't hide behind the problems. Take your place and do what you must do. Because it is your duty this morning. God expects it of you. I'm looking at the woman in the Bible. Somebody sent a beautiful message last night and I thought I'm going to share this. You see, we are the Ruths in this generation. We are the Elizabeths in this generation. We are the Deborahs, the ones who knocks the enemy out. We are the Esthers that must use our wisdom in difficult circumstances. We are the Mary Magdalene. Yes, we have an ugly past, but we are looking focused on King Jesus. We are all that and more this morning. God wants us to step out and step up. The Israelites didn't look. They were, hulle was meer behep oor hulle swaar kry. And they didn't realize that they are actually outnumbering the enemy. En net so wil God vir ons gebruik in ons toestand. He wants us to expand bigger than our circumstances. He wants us to stretch out far greater than what we can ever think this morning. I always say to the new converts, God uses us as rubber bands, also as an elastic bungee. He pulls us and He stretches us until we think we can't anymore. As ons elastic band aankyk, dan is hy maar so rond. But the moment you stretch Him out, you see the actual size of who He really is. And that is what God does with us in the circumstances. So I want to encourage you, body of Christ, use your circumstances to your advantage this morning. Don't sit and settle because what you see, ach, daar is maar seker hoe dit gaan wees. You stand up, you stretch out, you push forward this morning, and you shine for Jesus. The Lord bless you. Amen.